Alright, so we've just arrived in Bangkok and we're just going to go open our room. We have room number 251. This is an executive suite in the 5-star, so let's have a look. Alright, standard stuff. Let's pop that in there. Whoa, this is the living room. We have a living room. Look at this. Oh, comes with a nice little kitchen area. Okay. So this is what the room looks like. How is that for a living room? Because of an exercise bike? Never going to use that. Let's have a walk around and see what we've got. Okay, actually, our luggage has already been delivered, so it's sitting right here. So this is the bedroom. Comes with a TV. Look at the size of that bed. We get the king bed. Look at this. And then we've got here is, let's see, do we have much of a view? Not really. The view's pretty naff. Again, then what we got here is, what the hell? Oh, the hell is she doing here? Okay, so we have a perv window here for the bathroom. Let's have a look here. Bathtub. Look, shower closet. She's just ignore her, folks. She's not right in the head. All right, that's us. We'll do a walk around Bangkok later on tonight. Hopefully, hit the markets. We'll see what's going on. The markets. Oh. Check out the lobby. Look at that. Swanky. Alright folks, so we're back at the hotel and I've just jumped out of the shower, okay? So we went to the Silom market tonight and it was a bit of a bust, to be honest. Beyond the food stalls that I showed earlier, there's nothing there. The market actually doesn't exist anymore, believe it or not. Googled it and apparently the entire markets were shut down at the end of May last year, so there's nothing to look at. It's no longer a tourist attraction. Save your time, save your breath. Find a different market to go to. We've got one plan for tomorrow morning, so hopefully that'll be more successful. Let's see what happens. Good night for now. Good morning, folks. Just going to go get breakfast. Find this place that's supposed to be awesome, so let's check it out. Ah, they also do all day breakfasts here. All right, let's see what else is here. Oh, nice and French toast, pancakes. Lunch there. Don't care about lunch there just yet. Bit too early for that. We've got burgers, paninis. It's pretty standard coffee shop stuff. Okay, so this place is apparently famous for its hot chocolates here, okay? So what we've got is a standard dark hot chocolate. There's normal stuff. Very nice. And then we have what they call a Spanish thick. Look at this. Look at the consistency. It's not hot chocolate. It's like a pudding. Look at that. That is not a hot chocolate, but it looks really nice. Let's have a taste. Not too sweet, it's quite nice. I would maybe like some biscuits to dunk in it, but nice. Okay, so the first dish just come out. This is the banana waffle. It's got some cream on it. It's actually really, really big. If you compare the size of my hand, it's actually bigger than my hand. This thing is huge. So here, Polly's just gotta tuck in. Let's get a look at that. I'm just gonna shove it in your face.
get some ice cream. Yep, yeah, lovely. Shove it in your face. Like, watch this. You can just do a 360 here. Keep in mind, this is breakfast. This is not a good breakfast. Okay, so what we have is a very regular breakfast. Just got fried eggs, some bacon, a maple sauces, potatoes, mushrooms, some tomatoes. We got some sourdough bread. Very normal stuff, to be honest. Yo. Not to say that it's a Whopper, but a lot more traditional, a lot more normal as breakfast. Hi guys, so we've just arrived at Camping Fair. I can't pronounce that. Anyways, we're at the weekend market. It's going to be really big. Hoping to spend half a day here. Let's go and have a look to see what we can find. Okay, so it's actually extremely hot in here, but gonna try to find a mall to duck into in a sec, but to check this out. I think it's a bike rental shop. Bikes for days and days and days. Okay, it's actually really hot. It's 35 degrees today, so I'm just gonna try to get a bit. Alright, just making our way to the JJ Mall. It's supposedly pretty much the same stuff as the weekend market, but indoors, so let's see if we can find it. JJ Mall. I think it's very much like any other kind of market in Hong Kong. It's mostly tat, tailored really towards tourists. Nothing you would ever buy for yourself, so realistically, this is an excellent place to buy souvenirs. I've also been a little bit disappointed with the street food scene right now, but finally found something that's worth eating. So we got here, big bowl of squid. This is all here. Let me show you what's around. There's a boss. So we got all the squid. So we got one of these squid, and it's costing us 150 baht, which is approximately 30 odd Hong Kong dollars. It's pretty cheap. Let's see what else there is here. Got some quail eggs. Quite fancy some, but don't really have the appetite, so let's challenge that and hopefully we have enough of an appetite to eat something else. Oh, what's this? What's this? It's quite noisy around here. Let's go somewhere quieter so we can get some eats. Okay, so we've wandered into this bakery just to get out of the heat. Something caught our eye is that these things here, and these are mango sweets. What these actually are, if you see, they are dried mango wrapped up like roses. They come in individual little cups. Don't you see that? So that's pretty cool. Not too expensive. We're looking at 60 baht per container here. So what is that divided by 4.45? It's like under $20. So that's pretty good. Okay, we're at the Chong Non Si station now. We're going to a cooking class early this morning, and this lady here, Mai, is our little instructor, I guess. She's just checking our names out. We're going to do a bit of shopping, go up to the classroom and see what's on the menu this morning. On our way. So the group's finally all accounted for. Just a 10 minute walk to the kitchen. We've been divided into two groups and we've been put into the smaller group, which is nice. It's nice to be in a smaller group because you get more kind of individual time with the chef deal. So, I think we're going to go to the markets, maybe shop for some ingredients, have a look around before we actually head up, so looking forward to that. Okay, so the walk's a little bit further than I anticipated. Apparently we're almost there, but let me try to show you some of the group. These are some of the other guys that are taking classes with me. Wave. Okay, wait, I think that's enough. Let's go. Rock and chalk and call I want you. You need it, you go to the
ข้าวของเครื่องใช้ก็ยังอยู่ดีแต่ซีดีบอมมาลีกลับหายไปจะเก็บเงินสะสมซื้อทุกจุดจะผ่านไปเป็นสะดุดเธอก็เอาไปเอาข้าวของเงินทองฉันจะไม่ว่าและยาวเสื้อลายกระชากของฉันไป ทำไมถึงทำกับฉันได้ดูเธอทำ
Okay, so we are in Siam just now. Polly's away to dance class. She's booked. I'm not taking part in that. It doesn't start for 2 hours and it goes on for another 2 hours, so I've got 4 hours of free time. So now is a very good time to go and buy a little souvenir for her. It's actually, this place is supposedly like one of the main shopping districts, one of the main shopping intersections of Bangkok. So there's going to be a lot to walk around here. Let me just show the street I'm on. Okay, so basically there's like four or five different large shopping centers kind of all grouped together here. We'll have a look around and hopefully we can pick up something nice. Hey guys, look at this, look what I found. I found a Pablo's. Pablo is a very popular Japanese, I think specifically Osaka chain of cheesecake. Didn't know they had any outside of Japan. It's quite interesting to find one in Thailand. Let's see what they have here. Oh, strawberry cheesecake. That's different from the usual. Usually it's just regular cheesecake. Let's see if we can find it. Ah, here we go. So this is the stuff that they're normally known for. Of course, we have mango. Mango is, I think, the national fruit of Thailand. It's everywhere. They have a Harrods in Thailand. That's a bit over budget. It's not going to happen. Next. Alright, so we just had some time to kill and came out of a foot massage just there. Lovely, almost fell asleep. So, and then I was wandering around looking for a little present for Polly. You know, it's our 1 year anniversary. So I'm going to surprise her a little bit. I got her something from this shop. Can you see that? This is Naraya. Apparently it's like a Japanese kind of like bag shop. It's very popular supposedly. I've never heard of them, but the prices aren't even that expensive. If you look at that bag there, that's like 350 baht for that middle shelf big one there. That's, you divide that by 4.45 to get Hong Kong, so that's not even 100 Hong Kong dollars. It's pretty cheap. So I got her a little something. She doesn't know what I was getting her either. Gonna surprise her and look for a reaction. Yeah. 里边。快点，没电了。拜拜。
拜拜。
Alright, so we're still in Siam, and sit down and get a bit of early dinner tonight. It's only 6:30, but we're taking this place. It's called Bangkok Burger. With the hopes of getting like a local Thai flavored burger, and instead what we got was standard bacon cheese, double burger, some chicken tenders. Don't actually have any specialized kind of like Thai flavored burgers here. Bit of a disappointment, but I'm starving. A burger's always good, so no worries.
Alright, morning folks. This is our last morning in Bangkok. We've got a flight to catch early afternoon. So we're gonna go check out the hotel swimming pool before we check out and make our way back to Hong Kong. Hey there, folks. Thanks for joining us.
Bye.